Hi everyone, and welcome back to the second part of our Revit structural project tutorial. In today's video, we'll be covering the essential steps to add rebar or reinforcement to the structural element that we've created in the first part. But if you've missed the first part, you can catch up with the link in the top right of the screen, or you could check the one linked in the description below. But for now, let's jump into the reinforcement process. As you can see, I have launched Revit and opened the file that we've used in our previous tutorial. First thing to do is opening our first floor and change our graphic display options. Now I'm gonna pick the first element that I'm gonna add rebar to, but before that, let's create a section so we can view our model properly. In order to open this section, you could double click inside that circle or just find it in the section part in Project Browser. We don't need to view all the top floors, we could just work on the bottom floor. And we could change our graphic display as well, and most importantly, our level of detail. So we could view our rebar later. But in our section, we cannot view our columns. So we're gonna go back to a floor, foundation or first floor, and go to our section and make sure that our display or the range of our display reaches that column we want to view, which is using these little blue arrows to make it reach it. And once we can see the column, we can change our display option, for example, to hidden lines and start working on our reinforcement. We could, for example, start working with this beam. We're gonna go to structure and then all the way to rebar. If you don't have any shape families or rebar shape families loaded, you could either get your library online or you could request it in the comments. I'd be happy to share mine with you. Just select all the shapes folder and they will load automatically into your file. Now you could scroll down and choose the shape you want to work with. For example, I would start working with this one for this theme. You could use these handles and change the shape of your rebar to whichever suits you. Now in the properties tab, you could change the layout rule from one single rebar to, for example, multiple rebars to a fixed number or a fixed number with certain specific spacing between them. For example, if you want to change the color or the graphic of your rebar in this view specifically, you could right click, go to override graphics in view and choose either by elements or by category or by filter if you've already created filters. You could either change the surface patterns or the cut patterns. For now, let's work with the surface patterns. I'm gonna choose a solid pattern and I'm gonna choose blue. Before placing these bars, you could change the type of placement, whether it's parallel to the work plane or parallel to the cover or perpendicular to the cover. I'm going to choose the last option and I'm going to place my first bar, second, and then the last one. You could do it that way, but for a more precise way to create your rebars, I'm going to delete these. You could change whether it's single or fixed number and so on. So I'm going to delete these and I'm going to leave this one. And I'm gonna go with a fixed number and I'm gonna set the number to, for example, 4 and press apply. And now I have my 4 rebars, but I want to make sure that I want a specific spacing between them, which is what we always do. I'm gonna choose the option of number with spacing, set my spacing and set my number. If I want to move them, I could use the move tool. And also we could use the copy tool and create ones in the bottom part of my frame. I could also move them using my keyboard, the arrows in my keyboard. Now I'm going to create another section. So we could resume adding rebar to the rest of our project elements. Okay, now if I want to check the frames that I have added, the rebar frames that I have added earlier from this view, let's just hide these for now for better visibility. Okay, so these are my frames. They've been placed in the middle by default. Now we could go back to our other section and go to the rebar settings in the property tab and change the quantity, for example, change the spacing. We can review it in the other section. You could use the keyboard arrows to move it to whichever side you prefer to. Now let's try to minimize this. Okay, concerning the other rebars, you could change the hook at the start and the hook at the end. For example, you could use a hook with a 180 degree end, or a or another one with a 135 degree end. Now, if you want them to be facing each other, you could change the hook rotation. And we could do the same thing to the other end. And you could rotate each one of them individually. Now going back to the frames, we could change the spacing. We could work with that. Now let's go back to our 3D view. Make sure we have our level of detail set to fine. And we will try to view our rebars in here. Click Override Graphics in View. And make sure to set a high level of transparency to our beam. And we could also change the color of our rebar in here as well. If we chose by category, we'll have all the rebar in our model have the same color. If you choose by element, we'll only have this color or these graphical options only in this beam. Now passing to the next element, we're gonna be adding rebar to a column. Concerning our placement, we're gonna be using the first option. And we're gonna be setting a fixed number with spacing. We'll start with 2, and we will put 2 rebars. Check them in our section or in the 3D model. We could do the same thing, making sure that our column is transparent, so we could view our rebar in here as well. Now going back to the section, eventually we're going to be connecting the rebar in our column with the pad underneath it. So you could select it, use these arrows to slide it down. And then create your hooks at the end. You could either choose one of these in here, just like we did earlier in the beam, but you could also select it and choose the option of editing the sketch, pick a line, and create whichever type of hook you want. Something like that, for example. And we could do the same thing to the other rebar. Now we could go back to our rebar shape library and pick a frame for our column. We could simply set it to a fixed number or simply minimum or maximum spacing between frames. I'm gonna go with minimum spacing for this one. And now we're gonna pass to adding reinforcement to our pads. We're gonna go with a parallel to a workframe spacement, and we're gonna set a fixed number of rebars, for example 6, and we will set it. We could change the hook at the end to a 135 degree as well as at the start. No need to do any rotations in this example. We still need to add a couple of rebars. So let's go back to our browser and pick these. Change the placement to perpendicular to cover. And we could set them in here. Obviously change the spacing so it can cover the whole pad. Slide it a little bit down. And change the hook at the start and at the end to a 135 degree. Now checking our elements in our 3D view. This is the pad that we have been working on. Elevate the transparency and review the results. We could set the topo solid to wireframe so we could view everything. And that's it, that's the result for this tutorial. Obviously, when you're doing it, you're gonna have to be following your technical documents that specify the dimension and diameters of each bar and so on. This is mainly the process that you'd be following when adding reinforcement to your structural elements in Revit. I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope it was helpful. If you're interested in more Revit related videos, whether it's modeling, whether it's automating modeling or automating certain tasks with Dynamo, or managing your project or detecting clashes with Navisworks, you could check around the rest of my playlists. And yes, like and subscribe if you like my content, and thank you for watching.